Hello students, once again welcome to Saraswati's School to Vagwala Borsal. So students, I hope you are fine. So in the first part of chapter 4, My Elder Brother, we have learned about two brothers, Bayan and Munna. Both they were talking each other about study and other things. But and if you remember in the first part, Munna and Bhaiya. Munna is younger than Bhaiya. Bhaiya is elder brother. So Bhaiya gives advice, one suggestion for study to Munna. But Munna doesn't like to sit for long hours to study. And Bhaiya, he likes to study. He likes to write same word for 20 times and poems several times in beautiful letters. So that was the thing. And Bhaiya at last, in that part, Bhaiya prepares a timetable for studying for Munna. So when the timetable is prepared, Bhaiya shows in timetable, and when he shows the timetable, when he sees the timetable, Munna says, "But when's the time to play?" So Munna says, "Bhaiya, what is, when's the time to play in this timetable?" So that time Bhaiya says again, "Play, what is the need, Munna? What is the need for playing for you?" Munna says, "Oh, I love the green fields." Munna says, "I love green fields. Bhaiya, I love green fields. Even the gentle breeze. I want to jump up like a football. I like touch and go and hututu sounds of the body." What Munna says, "Yeah, I want to touch and go and hututu sounds of the kakadi. The hurry and flurry of volleyball pulls me like a man." So what Munna says, "Bhaiya, I like to play and I like to jump like a football. I like touch and move the sounds of the body, and hurry and flurry of the volleyball pulls me like a magnet." It means Munna is attracted by games. Munna likes to play games and he likes to wander for playing with his friends. And as soon as I am on the field, it means when Munna is on the field, he is attracted by the games, he is attracted by the friends for play. So this is the first scene of the story, My Elder Brother. Now we will start seeing two of these stories. Now in scene two, what happens, friends? So after the exam, the final exam is over and the results are out. It means the final exams are finished and results are out. So that time Bhaiya says, alas, Bhaiya becomes unhappy. Why? Because Bhaiya has failed the exam once again. Bhaiya says, alas, I have failed once again. So that time Munna replies him. Munna says, oh, but Bhaiya, I have passed and topped my class. Now there is only 2 years difference between us. So students, we have already learned in the first part, Munna says to Bhaiya, "Munna, you are 3 classes ahead of me." But now Munna has passed the 1 class and there is only 2 classes difference between them. So Bhaiya has failed the exam, whereas Munna has passed the class. It means passed the exam in his class. So there is only 2 classes difference between them. So that is Munna says. Okay. Now Bhaiya replies it. "But my dear brother," Bhaiya says, "Munna, you are my brother. Don't be so proud and don't think that you are smart. You have passed once again. That's good. And you have passed once again only 1 class and here. But don't think that you are smart. in a Gulli Danda game, you might get lucky. In a Gulli Danda game, you might get lucky and hit a goal and hit a goal. But that doesn't mean that you have mastered the game. You have to work hard to be successful in life. So what your bhaiya gives me advice that you might get lucky one time. Once you might get lucky, but it doesn't mean that you have mastered. Now master means that you become particular expert in that field. That doesn't mean once you get a goal or once you pass the exam, it means that it doesn't mean that you are expert of that game or you are expert in particular field. But you need to do work hard to become successful in life. So that is the thing for Nunai Bhaiya. Or geometry. In higher classes, you will understand the importance of hurdle. What Bhaiya says, basis when you have to study subject like algebra or geometry in higher classes, that time you will understand the importance of hurdle. In geometry, if one word is A, C, B. Instead of A, B, C. If someone writes A, C, B instead of A, B, C, you won't get marks for this answer. The examiner will not spare you. The examiner will not spare you. It means if you write A, C, B instead of A, B, C, the answer is marked wrong and examiners will not spare you. They want you to learn one by one. They want you to learn word by word from the textbook. So Bhaiya informs Munna that when you have to study subject like algebra or geometry in higher classes, you will understand the importance of
time for school or else. What Muna says, thank God
It means it's a one kind of a story for him. So he thanks God that it's a time for school, or else otherwise the scolding would have gone on and on. Okay students, so now scene 3. Now in scene 3 of this story, what happens? The results were out. Once again, and it so happened that Munna passed and Vaidya failed again. Vaidya was really upset. Vaidya was really upset. And on the other hand, Munna was also sad. Why? He was also seeing his brother so unhappy. So that time Munna says to his older brother Vaidya, talking about how I am lucky, I can pass easily, I need not study so hard. Now I can play games with my friends and fly kites. But I should still be very careful that Vaidya does not.
They know more
So Bhaiya says everything to Munna that Baba and Ma have more experience than them. So that the Munna says, Bhaiya, I am sorry. Now Munna was crying and says, Bhaiya, I am sorry. What you say is true. So that the Bhaiya hugs Munna. Bhaiya, I also like to play and fly kites. So when Bhaiya hugs Munna, and of course Bhaiya says, I am elder brother of you and I am 5 years older than you. I also like to play and fly kites. Okay? But if I also play, then how can I watch out for you? What Bhaiya says? I also like to play and fly kites. But if I play, then how can I watch out for you? You are my responsibility. You are my responsibility. So Bhaiya says, Munna, you are my responsibility. Munna listens this everything and Munna says, I love you, Bhaiya. So dear students, here Bhaiya is told Munna, but whatever is told, is told Munna for his matter. Okay? Why? Because they both are living in our state and Munna was the responsibility of Bhaiya. Munna was the responsibility of Bhaiya. Munna. Okay students, after the explanation of the part 2 of my little story, let's have an exercise. Answer the following questions. First question is, why was Munna not happy with the timetable that Bhaiya made for him? Once again, why was Munna not happy with the timetable that Bhaiya made for him? So the answer is, Munna was not happy with the timetable that Bhaiya made for him, because there is no time. There was no time to play anything. Once again, Munna was not happy with the timetable that Bhaiya made for him, because there was no time to play anything. Second, how do you think Munna felt when his brother was so strict with him? So answer for this question is, Munna became so sad and began to cry when his brother was so strict with him. Bhaiya was strict with him because it was his duty to take care that Munna would not waste his time, and he wanted Munna to study hard. Once again, Munna became so sad and began to cry when his brother became so strict with him. Bhaiya was so strict with him because it was his duty to take care that Munna would not waste his time, and he wanted Munna to study hard. Next question, whose character do you like more, Munna's or Bhaiya's? Why? So which character do you like, Munna's or Bhaiya's? Why? So your answer, you can give answer in favor of Munna's, or you can give answer in favor of Bhaiya's. But as for me, I favor of Bhaiya's character, because Bhaiya is the elder brother of Munna. So I like Bhaiya's character more than Munna's character, because it appears Bhaiya was a bookworm. It appears Bhaiya was a bookworm. Still, he did not pass the test. But in fact, Bhaiya had more experience than Munna. Bhaiya had more experience than Munna, and Bhaiya was his responsibility. So he was so strict with Munna because he loved him. He was not good at study, but he had more experience. Next, fourth, what did Bhaiya say about Ma and Baba? What did Bhaiya say about Ma and Baba? So your answer is, Bhaiya said that Ma had not, so sorry, what did Bhaiya say about Ma and Baba? Bhaiya say about Ma that Ma had never gone to school and Baba had only passed 5th class. Once again, Bhaiya say about Ma that Ma had never gone to school and Baba had passed only 5th class. Fifth number, what does Bhaiya think about understanding? So your answer is Bhaiya thinks about understanding that understanding doesn't come from reading books. It comes from experience. Specifically, students, Bhaiya thinks about understanding that reading adds understanding from experiences. So please, dear students, remember here, Bhaiya thinks about understanding that understanding doesn't come from reading. We can get understanding by experiences. I hope you understood this.